Welcome, everybody. So I haven't taught a class in a really long time. For those of you who know me, I broke my arm and had a very long surgery. And I'm definitely still in recovery. And you can kind of see what's going on there. And so I will not be able to bear weight on this arm at all. Yet I teach a winter study starting on Tuesday on being whole and kind of finding meditation and mindfulness and yoga and using those as coping skills when you're handled adversity. And that's what we're doing. And this is my daughter, Ruby. And she's just happy to join us. So everything I do, I'll probably do one-sided. But as you know, the rule in yoga is whatever you do on one side, you have to do on two sides, unless you have a broken arm or a broken leg, which I've also taught with. I guess I'm just clumsy. Anyway, so let's begin. We'll begin just in a simple tabletop position. And inhale, looking up at the ceiling. Exhale, looking down at the navel for a cat. Inhale, looking up for a cow. And exhale, looking down. And inhale, up. And exhale, down. And then just coming to a neutral spine, we'll take our left arm forward and our right leg back. Inhaling here. Exhale, elbow to knee. Inhaling back out. Exhale, elbow to knee. Inhaling back out. Exhale, taking the left arm around and grabbing hold of the right foot. So as you can see, I don't have full motion of that left arm. I may not, but try and gain it back. And bringing the left arm forward again, right leg back, slowly releasing the palm back down to the mat. And then taking the right arm forward and the left leg back. Inhaling here. So I can't do this because I can't put pressure on my left arm. So I'll just take my left arm forward and my left arm back. My left arm forward, my left leg back. Inhaling here, but you're doing your right. Exhale, elbow to knee. Inhaling out and exhale, elbow to knee. Inhaling out, exhale, elbow to knee. And then taking your hand around, grabbing hold of the foot and kicking the foot into the hand, feeling a nice quad stretch. Then straightening them back out and coming back to a tabletop. Inhaling as you gaze up, exhale, coming into your first downward facing dog. You're gonna pedal your legs out. Getting a nice calf stretch here. And on an inhale, bringing the right leg up. Bend the knee, open the hip, making some hip circles in one direction. You don't have to do it on one hand, only I do. And then bringing the right foot between your hands. The left knee comes down. Slowly, both arms come up, sinking into that left hip flexor. Feeling a nice deep stretch, getting those arms up overhead. And then bringing the palms back down to the mat, tucking the left toes under, and coming back to your downward facing dog, pedaling the legs out. Now we'll take the left leg up. Inhale, bend your knee, open your hip, making some hip circles. And then slowly bring the left foot between your hands. The right knee comes down, and the arms come up overhead as you sink into that right side. Deep stretch here. And then bringing the palms back down, tucking the right toes under, coming back to your downward facing dog. Again, pedaling the feet out. On an inhale, bending the knees, gazing forward. Exhale, walking your feet to your hands. Inhale, halfway up, and exhale, forward fold. Inhale as the arms come all the way up overhead. And exhale, bring your hands to heart center. So I'll actually try to move this so we get a better view, kind of what's going on. that's a better view. So we're going to come into our sun salutations. Inhale the arms up. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, coming back to your plank pose. Inhaling in plank. Exhale, either knees, chest, chin, or full chaturanga. Inhale to baby cobra. And exhale back to your downward facing dog. Breathing in through your nose and out through your mouth. On an inhale, bend your knees, gazing forward. Exhale, walking or hopping your feet to your hands. Inhale, halfway lift. And exhale, forward fold. Inhale, arms all the way up overhead. And exhale, hands to heart center. Inhaling the arms up overhead. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, coming back to your plank pose. Inhaling in plank. Exhale, either knees, chest, chin, or chaturanga. Inhale, baby cobra or upward dog. And exhale, coming back to your downward facing dog. Breathing in through your nose and out through your mouth. Inhale, bending your knees, gazing forward. Exhale, walking or hopping your feet to your hands. Inhale, halfway lift. And exhale, forward fold. Inhale, the arms all the way up overhead. And exhale, hands to heart center. Inhaling, arms up overhead. Exhale, coming into sun salutation B, sitting in chair pose, Utkatasana. There really is no good way to mention this. Utkatasana. Inhaling in chair. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, coming back to plank pose. Inhale, plank. Exhale, chaturanga, knees, chest, chin. Inhale to baby cobra, upward dog. And exhale. That's annoying, isn't it? Back to your downward facing dog. Inhale that right leg up. Exhale the right foot between the hand. Back heel comes down, slowly rising into your warrior one. Inhaling here. Exhale, palms come down. Back to a plank pose. Inhale, plank. Exhale, chaturanga, knees, chest, chin. Inhale, baby cobra, upward dog. And exhale, back to your downward facing dog. Now we take the left leg up and bring the left foot between the hands. Right heel down, warrior one. Inhaling here. And exhale, palms come down, left leg back. Inhale, plank. Exhale, your knees, chest, chin, or chaturanga. Inhale, baby cobra, upward dog. And exhale, back to your downward facing dog. Breathing in through your nose and sighing out through your mouth. Inhale, bending your knees, gazing forward. Exhale, walking or hopping your feet to your hands. Inhale, halfway lift. And exhale, forward fold. Inhale, sitting into your chair pose, Utkatasana. Exhale, standing up, Tadasana. Inhale, arms up overhead. Exhale, chair. Holding chair here. Inhaling here. Exhale, hands to the heart center. Twist over to the right. Inhaling here. Exhale, arms come back up. Inhaling here. Exhale, hands to the heart center. Twist over to the left. Inhaling here. Exhale, arms up. Inhaling for one more breath and then folding forward, feeling that nice strengthening those quad muscles. Inhaling, halfway lift. And exhale, this time we'll just come back into a downward facing dog. Inhale that right leg up. Exhale the right foot between your hands. Back heel comes down, warrior one. Inhaling here. Exhale, we open to a warrior two. Inhale, reversing the warrior. And exhale, coming into extended side angle. Inhale, reversing the warrior. Exhale, extended side angle. Straightening the right leg, coming into a triangle pose. Inhaling here. Exhale, feeling a nice deep stretch. Left arm comes down as you fold over that right leg, coming into pyramid or Parsvottanasana. Inhaling.
And exhale.
Slowly bending the right knee and coming back into a plank pose. Inhale, plank. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, upward dog. And exhale, coming back to a downward dog. So I get to skip those things because I have one arm. Remember that. Inhale, that left leg comes up. Exhale, the left foot through. Warrior one. Inhale here. Exhale, open into a warrior two. Inhale to reverse the warrior. Exhale, extend at side angle. Inhale, reverse the warrior. Exhale, extend at side angle, straightening the left leg and coming into a triangle pose. Feeling a nice stretch here. Inhaling. Exhale, that right arm comes down, folding over the left leg, pyramid pose. Inhaling here. And exhaling, deep stretch in that hamstring. And bending the left knee, coming back to a plank pose. Inhale, plank. Exhale, knees, chest, chin, or chaturanga. Inhale, upward dog. And exhale, back to your downward facing dog. Breathing in through your nose. And sighing out through your mouth. Inhale, that right leg comes up. Exhale, the right foot between your hands. Left heel stays lifted, coming into your high lunge. Inhaling here. Exhale, hands to your heart center. Slowly kicking forward, balancing on the right leg, coming into your warrior three. Inhaling here. And exhale, palms come down, standing split.
Way.
Left hand to the left hip, opening up and coming to half moon pose. Ardha Chandrasana. Inhaling here. Exhale, the left palm comes back down. Inhaling your hands back to heart center, warrior three. Exhale, slowly bringing that left knee into the chest. Left foot comes around on top of the right leg. That's right. We're coming into eagle pose. Left arm comes underneath the right arm. Garudasana. Inhaling here. Exhale, taking that left leg back. Warrior three with eagle arms. And then coming back into your high lunge with eagle arms. Releasing the arms up overhead back to your high lunge. Inhaling here. Exhale, opening to a nice open warrior two. Inhale, reverse the warrior. And exhale, extend the side angle pose. Coming back into that nice, delicious triangle pose, straightening the right leg. Right. And then coming back into that forward fold, Parsvottanasana. Inhaling here. Exhale, bending the right knee. And coming back into your plank pose. Inhale, plank. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, up dog. And exhale, downward facing dog. And taking it to the left side. Inhale, as the left leg comes up. And exhale, the left foot between your hands, slowly rising into your high lunge. Inhaling here. Exhale, your hands come to heart center. Slowly coming into your warrior three, balancing on that left leg. Inhaling here, always grabbing onto a prop if you can't find, if you don't, the balance, no judgment. Exhale, palms come down, standing split. Inhale as the right hand comes to your right hip and opening up into Ardha Chandrasana. And taking the balance if you have no left arm. And then the right palm comes back down, standing split. Inhaling your hands to your heart center. Exhale, the right leg comes up, right leg over the left, and the right arm underneath the left arm. Garudasana. Inhaling here. Exhale, taking that right leg back, coming into your high lunge with eagle arms. Slowly the arms come up overhead. Inhaling here and exhale, opening to that delicious warrior two. Inhale to reverse the warrior. And exhale, coming into extended side angle. Coming into that triangle pose as you straighten the left leg. Right arm comes down, folding over that left leg. Bending the left knee. This time you'll come back into a plank pose and you'll come over onto your right palm, coming into Vashisthasana. So balancing on your side.
Got it.
You can also bring your left foot forward for extra balance. Staying here, or maybe taking that left leg into a tree pose.
I'm not staying here.
And then slowly coming back to a plank. Inhale, plank. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, baby cobra, upward dog. And exhale, back to a downward facing dog. And we'll take it over to the other side. Of course, I'll do the same side. You're going to inhale forward to a plank, putting your left palm down and coming over onto your left side, coming into Vashisthasana. So I'll just show you some other variations. You can just lift that left leg. You have the tree option. You can take your left piece fingers to your left big toe and try to straighten it out.
I'm staying here.
And then bringing it back down, coming back to a plank. Inhale, plank. Exhale, knees, chest, chin.
Yes, finally.
Inhale, baby cobra. And exhale, back to a downward facing dog. Breathing in through your nose and out through your mouth. Inhale, bend your knees, gazing forward. Exhale, walking or hopping feet to hands. Inhale, halfway lift. And exhale, forward fold. Inhale, the arms all the way up overhead. And exhale, bringing hands to heart center. So coming into some balancing pose, taking our right foot to the inside of our left thigh for tree, hands to heart center.
Whoa.
Inhaling here, exhale, arms come up overhead.
You can't do it on your knee.
Nope, can't do it on your knee. You can do it on your thigh or your shin. Palms come back. Right knee is going to come forward. So you're still stabilizing on my left leg, taking your right palm to the side, grabbing hold of the top of the right foot. Left arm comes forward as you slowly come forward into a dancer pose. Natarajasana, if you always pronounce it wrong. And slowly you inhale, come up. Again, you're still not putting that right leg down. So arms are up overhead, putting your hands to your right knee. Or maybe taking your right piece fingers, bringing them to the right big toe, and extending that leg out to the side. Maybe bringing that forward, bending the right knee, taking eagle pose, right leg wraps over the left, right arm underneath. And I promise we'll put the right leg down soon. Bringing it back up.
No.
One last time, we'll take the right heel to the left hip crease. So coming into a half lotus position. So you can either fold forward, getting a nice deep stretch in that outer hip.
What's the other option?
Or you can stay standing. And if you can, take a bound lotus, where you take your right arm around and grab hold of the right big toe. Stabilizing on that strong left leg. Just imagine it as being strong as the biggest tree in Yosemite Forest. Slowly unraveling, and now I promise, shaking the legs out. Now, let's see if I can remember it on the other side. Bringing your left foot to the inner right thigh, coming into your tree pose, hands to heart center. Inhaling here, exhale, maybe growing that tree. Inhaling here, and exhaling, feeling grounded and centered, hands to heart center. Left knee comes forward, left palm comes by your side. Gonna take that palm and slowly this is hard for me because my left arm doesn't work. But slowly kick in to a dancer pose.
Oh.
Inhaling here.
Got it.
And exhaling.
Got it.
Slowly
oh,
again.
No.
Don't fall into your mommy. Bringing the right knee into the chest. Again, feeling that strong right leg. This time you either have your hands here or you can take your left piece fingers through your left big toe and extend. I'm not able to do that, so I'm going to take a different variation, taking the right piece fingers to the left big toe and extending and getting a nice stretch in the IT band, which you can do as well.
Whoa, no, not.
Inhaling here and exhaling. Left leg now comes over the right leg, left arm underneath, coming into our eagle wrap.
The right leg, left leg.
Slowly unraveling the last pose before you put our left leg down will be that half lotus. Your left heel into your right hip crease. Either staying here, taking the wrap, which I can't do, or bowing forward and getting that nice stretch in that hip.
I'm staying.
And the leg.
Okay.
Slowly rising back up and releasing and shaking it out. Good job. And we'll come back to the front of our mats. Inhale as the arms come up overhead and exhale, folding forward. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, coming back to a downward facing dog. We're doing some yoga. Inhaling here. Exhale, for short, coming forward into a plank. Inhale and plank. Exhale, knees, chest, chin, or chaturanga. Inhale, baby cobra. And exhale, back to your downward facing dog. Breathing in through your nose. And sighing out through your mouth. On an inhale, we'll bend our knees. And exhale, we'll jump through.
Jump.
And coming through into a boat pose, Navasana. Inhaling here. Exhale, Ardha Navasana, half boat. Inhaling up. Exhaling down. Inhale up. Exhale down. Inhale up. Exhale down. Inhaling, grabbing your knees. And then rocking forward and back.
Yeah, you want to rock? Rock.
Getting a nice spinal massage. And then eventually, you'll rock all the way up into your forward fold. Inhaling here. And exhaling. Inhale the arms up overhead. And exhale, hands to heart center. I'll move this so you can see the hole. Hands to heart center.
How do that?
Inhale the arms up overhead. And exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. And exhale, coming back to a downward facing dog. Inhaling here. Exhale, bending the knees. Again, jumping your feet through and coming to a boat pose. Inhale, boat. Exhale, half boat. Inhale, boat. Exhale, half boat. Inhale, boat. Exhale, half boat. Now inhale, coming up, taking your peace fingers to your big toes and extending the legs out to the side. Bringing the feet together again. Again, rocking forward and back.
Rock together and I even want to rock.
And rocking all the way up eventually into your forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. And exhale, forward fold. Inhale, arms up overhead, and exhale, hands to heart center. Inhaling the arms up overhead, and exhale, folding forward. Inhale, halfway lift, and exhale. We're just going to stand in a standing split on our left leg. Inhaling here. Exhale, bring your left hand to your left hip. So we're coming to reverse half moon. The left arm comes up. So you'll feel a deep stretch in that outer right leg, thigh, T-band. Inhale, exhale, that right leg will come down. You're coming in your low twisted lunge. Inhaling here and exhale, both palms will come to the inside of that right foot, left foot. And slowly you'll bring both palms, or for me, just the one palm, down to the forearm, down to the mat, coming into your lizard. Rocking it forward and back, getting a nice deep stretch. And slowly coming back to your palms and coming back to a downward facing dog. Inhaling here and exhaling. On an inhale, the right leg will come up. Exhale, the right foot will come through. And you're going to come into your standing split this time on your right leg. I'm taking your rotation on this side, right hand to the right hip as we twist and open. To the right. So I have to do it without putting my hand down. It's a little bit difficult. Bringing that right arm back down. And then you're going to come into your low twisted lunge on the other side. So I will just bring my arm here, but your arm will be on the ground. Okay. Bringing both palms to the inside of that right foot, coming down to your forearms. Lizard pose. Slowly coming back to your palms and coming back to your downward facing dog. Inhaling here and exhaling. And bring your right leg up. Exhale your right foot between your hands. We're going to come to parallel those feet to the side wall. So coming into a wide-legged forward fold. Inhaling here and exhale, folding forward. Right palm down on the mat. Inhale, the left arm comes up and exhale. Left palm on the mat. Inhale here. The right arm comes up and exhale it down. Inhaling, looking up and exhale, folding forward. For those of you who do have an inversion practice, you can now definitely take your inversion, either a tripod with both palms down, or if you want to just come into a traditional headstand, coming in a traditional headstand. I can't do it yet with one arm, but I can show you how to do it. So inhaling here and exhaling. So you get the benefits of an inversion as long as your head is below your heart. Whoa. And my mat just slipped off. Let me move my mat back. But staying in your wide-legged forward fold. And then inhale, bringing both palms to heart center. Exhale, bending the left knee, right toes up. Coming into Skandasana. Deep stretch that inner right thigh. Inhaling up and exhale, bend. Inhale up, exhale, bend. Inhale up, exhale, bend. Your arms can always be down on the floor. Then inhaling, coming up. Exhale, folding forward. Inhale your hands to your hips. Exhale, slowly coming up, bring it into goddess. So your toes are out, your heels are in, arms come up on the inhale, and exhale, knees bend and arms bend, goddess pose. Inhale, bringing your shoulder blades together, and exhale, bring your arms or your elbows together. Inhale, opening the chest, and exhale, rounding the spine. Inhale, open, exhale, rounding, and then maybe bring your arms to side, trying to lift up onto your toes, lifting the heels, inhaling, and exhaling, heels come down, straightening the arms and legs, coming into a star, inhaling here, Exhale, bending the right knee, coming into your warrior two. Inhale, release the warrior. And exhale, cartwheeling the hands down and taking the right leg back into a downward facing dog. Inhale, the left leg up. Exhale, the left foot through. Now again, coming into your coming into your wide legged forward fold. Inhale, look up. And exhale, folding forward. Again, if you have an inversion in your practice, taking that. Otherwise, just hanging out here, feeling a nice grounding. Exactly. If you're not in an inversion, we're going to inhale. We're going to walk our hands over to the right leg as we fold over the right leg, getting a deep stretch. And inhale, bringing hands over to left leg. Exhaling here for a deep stretch. Slowly bring the palms back underneath you. So from here, we're either going to come into a half Hanumanasana or full. So your left toes are going to turn out. You're going to either bring your left knee, your right knee down to the ground, straighten your left leg and sit back, coming into a half Hanumanasana. Or you're going to come into a full Hanumanasana or split. Left leg back, right leg back. Inhaling here. And exhale, just coming into a comfortable position. Exactly. Slowly, if you're in that split or half Hanumanasana, slowly you're going to tuck those toes under, coming back into your wide-legged forward fold, and then we'll take it to the other side. So again, the right toes turn out. You want to do half, you bend that left knee, and just straighten that right leg. If you want to come into full, you'll bring the left, right leg all the way forward, and the left leg all the way back. And then slowly you'll tuck the toes under and you'll come back into your wide-legged forward fold. Inhale, bringing your hands to your hips. Exhale, slowly coming up. Heels in, toes out. Inhale, star. And exhale, goddess. This time we'll take a different arm variation. So you'll take your right arm underneath your left, coming into eagle arms. Maybe swaying from side to side in your goddess pose. Then inhaling your arms up, taking it to the other side, left arm underneath. Still swaying side to side, feeling your pelvic floor muscles working and your quads. Slowly the arms come up overhead, straightening the leg, star pose, and then bending into warrior two, facing the front of the mat. Inhales, reverse the warrior, and exhale, cartwheeling the hands down, and I'm bringing that left leg back to a downward facing dog. Breathing here. Inhale and exhale, releasing the knees down to the ground, coming into a wide legged child's pose, bringing your arms out in front of you. Bringing your arms out in front of you. Inhaling here. Exhale, walking your hands over the right. Deep stretch. Inhale here. Exhale, walking your arms over to the left. And a deep stretch. And slowly from our nice child's pose, we're going to come into a dolphin pose. Yeah. So you're going to have both forearms down on the mat. Tuck your toes under. I'm going to have one forearm on the mat and tuck my toes under. So here you are in dolphin pose. You guys have both forearms on the mat. You can inhale, bringing one leg up. Exhale, one leg down. Inhale, the other leg up. Exhale, down. Or if you have a forearm stand, coming into a forearm stand. I have not mastered that on my one arm. And I think my orthopedics might really shoot me if I try to. So staying in dolphin, then slowly coming back down, If you're in your inversion or in your dolphin, coming back into a child's pose. And then slowly coming into a seated position at the front of your mat or in the middle of your mat. And taking some floor positions here, taking your right leg out to the side, left foot into the inner right thigh, right piece fingers around the right big toe. Inhale the left arm up and exhale, folding over. Inhaling here and exhaling. It should feel really good. You have tight lower breathing muscles, intercostal muscles between your ribs. Inhaling both arms up and exhale, folding over that right leg. It doesn't matter if you touch your toes, it doesn't matter if you touch your shins. If you do touch your toes, you want an extra calf stretch. Kind of pulling on your toes, feeling an extra calf stretch. And slowly coming up, reversing sides. Left leg out, right foot into the inner left thigh. Left piece fingers around the left big toe. Right arm up and extending over. Looking underneath that right armpit. Your armpit. There you go. You don't have to do a full arc. You could just be here. You could be here. You could be here. It does not matter. We're getting a side stretch with those side muscles. Now we'll inhale and come up, and now we'll get the stretch on our hamstrings as we fold forward.
This one's better.
Again, if you want that calf stretch. Pushing on that foot, getting a nice calf stretch. Slowly coming back up, we're going to take shin to shin pose or fire log pose. So right shin down, left shin on top of the right shin. So you have to bend this leg. Or as much as you can, you'll inhale, come up. And exhale, you'll rock your hands forward. And for some of you, this could be just really easy and you might not feel much of a stretch. If that's the case, there's an arm variation where you do feel the stretch. You can take your right arm behind you and then your left arm behind you, which I can't quite do, but you can imagine. You can take a string and then you can slowly shift forward. And slowly you'll come up and shake out the arms and you'll switch sides. So left shin down, right shin on top of the left shin. And you'll inhale here. And exhale again, trying to walk your hands forward. Maybe you try the arm variation. So for this time, it'd be the right arm over, leaving the left arm around, or was it the other way? Yeah, it was the right arm over and left arm around.
Okay.
Inhaling here and exhale, folding forward. Slowly coming back up. From fire log, we'll come into rocking the baby pose. I can only rock it with one arm. So if I'm rocking the baby, you can take that arm over. You can extend the leg up. You can take an arm balance, which I can't demonstrate, but I can walk you through. Or you can just continue to walk the baby. Rock the baby. So that for the arm balance, Your right arm knee is over your right shoulder, left palm by your side, and then your right palm by your side. Your toes would come together and you would lift yourself up, engaging your core. You would slowly come down and we take it to the other side. So holding onto our left leg, rocking the baby Again, now you're going to try to get that left leg over the left shoulder. You can come into a compass type pose, which would look like this. Or you can try three. Or if you have two hands, you can try to come into the arm balance, that left shoulder, knees over, Astavakrasana. Both palms will come by your side. Your legs come together and you'll slowly lift yourself up. From here, we'll bring the soles of our feet together, knees apart.
Butterfly.
Yes, butterfly. Inhaling out and exhale. You can either bring your heels closer to your pelvic floor and try to get your knees down. So that's a different type of stretch. Or you can bring them further and try to get your head down to your smelly toes.
I'm butterfly.
Or you can butterfly. I'm going to bring my heels closer to my pelvic floor, taking my elbows into the inside of my knees and slowly try to come down. Slowly we'll come up. Now we'll come to lie on our backs, doing some back bends. So we'll start off with a bridge. So inhaling here and exhale, bringing your palms into the mat. And you'll wiggle your shoulder blades together if you have two arms, lifting yourself up, feeling inhaling and exhaling, finding stillness and strength in this pose, slowly coming down, rocking your knees from side to side. And we'll take another bridge pose here again. Inhaling, slowly coming up. Here, if you want to try to take some balancing, bring one leg up, releasing that leg. Bring the other leg up, releasing that leg. Keep on going, one leg, down, other leg, down. One more time, up, down. Up, down, holding here for one breath, slowly releasing down to the ground. Windshield wipe, bring your legs from side to side. Mm-hmm. Now, if you want to come into a full wheel, I can walk you through it. I can't do it because I don't have two arms, but you can bring your palm to, so it's facing your ear, so your fingers are facing towards your body, both for both sides. So from here, you would inhale and exhale and come to your crown of your head. So you have both arms on the ground. So here, you're on the crown of your head. You're going to inhale. And on the next exhale, you would lift yourself up into a full wheel or Dhanurasana. And you'll hold here. And then slowly coming down, upper spine, middle spine, lower spine. Windshield wipe your legs back and forth. And then we'll come into a gentle spinal twist. Legs over to the right side, maybe the left leg over on top of the right. Gazing over the left shoulder. Breathing here. Inhaling up. Exhale over to the left. And then inhaling up, squeezing your knees into your chest, rocking from side to side. Then you can either come straight into Shavasana, or you can come with your soles of your feet together, knees apart, Supta Baddha Konasana. One hand to your belly, one hand to your heart. Feeling your belly rise and fall with each inhalation and exhalation. Staying here, coming into full Shavasana. It's unbelievable how I can't even do corpse pose. Well, trying to find the light, the stillness, and the peace on some of these darker winter days. Happy New Year, everybody. I hope for a good 2023. Bye.